and basketball on WMIX and WMIXSports.com is powered by the official voice of Lady Rams Athletics, Community First Bank of the Heartland. Welcome back to personal banking.
Now, Vernon, Lady Rams basketball is also presented in part by
Red Lake College. Save thousands on your college education. Log on to rlc.edu. One stop for in America in Mount Vernon. State Farm Insurance Agent Tony Wilt. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. Second Chance Auto on Route 142 East in Mount Vernon. Winning Edge. See what they can customize at winningedgeusa.com. Schmidt Chevrolet Cadillac of Mount Vernon. And also by Purcell Tire of Mount Vernon. Banterra Bank. Banking with local style. The Orthopedic Center of Southern Illinois. Landers Collision Centers of Mount Vernon and Salem. Big or small, Landers fixes them all. Schmidt Ford of Salem. People's National Bank. Ford Square and King City Chrysler. You can count on us. And Bird Watson Drug of Mount Vernon. Two locations to serve you better. We take you to the WMIX Sports Mobile Studios for the Landers Collision Center's pregame show. Mount Vernon Lady Rams basketball starts now.
Memorial Gymnasium in Herrin tonight for senior night for the Herrin Lady Tigers as the Mount Vernon Lady Rams look to clinch at least a 500 record in 2015-16. Lady Rams are 13-13 overall. They finished their conference race at 6-4 in third place on Tuesday night. With Danny Czerwinski, I'm Chris Hugo. Glad to be here with you for your Landers Collision Center's pregame show. Big or small, Landers fixes them all. Call 1-888-LANDERS. That's 1-888-LANDERS. 94.1 FM tonight. You can watch us live at WMIXSports.com for all of your streaming video needs. We'll be back at it tomorrow night, Shagnon Gymnasium for MVTHS Hall of Fame night against the Carbondale Terriers. Can't wait for that. Can't wait for our special edition of the Saturday Sports Show. That'll be on AM 940 on a Saturday. We have plenty more to tell you about, especially about this one between the Lady Rams and the Lady Tigers. This is Lady Rams basketball powered by Community First Bank.
Hi, this is Steve Downs, Vice President of Agricultural Lending with Community First Bank. Operating your farm operation is extremely challenging in today's farm economy. Your operation needs a solid partner that understands the issues you face while providing solutions that make sense for you. At Community First Bank, we're dedicated to meeting the needs of local farmers just like you. Give me a call today at 618-244-3000 to see how we can help with your farming operation. Community First Bank, with locations in Mount Vernon, Woodlawn, Dixon, Ina. Welcome back to Personal Banking, member FDIC.
Here's Jeff Schmidt for Schmidt Chevrolet Cadillac of Mount Vernon.
February is truck month at Schmidt Chevrolet Cadillac. You know, they've redesigned the front end of the Silverado, and it really looks sharp. We've had a lot of people come and look at them, and they just really have fallen in love with this truck. And, you know, it's the hardest working, longest lasting truck on the market. And there's a reason that we sell so many of them at Schmidt Chevrolet, because we've really got some good deals going on, and we really need trade-ins.
Schmidt Chevrolet Cadillac of Mount Vernon, 3423 Broadway in Mount Vernon.
Ford Watson offers two convenient locations to serve you here in Mount Vernon. Our locally owned Health Mart Pharmacy at 3401 Broadway provides dedicated and specialized pharmacy services, including flu vaccines, a convenient drive-thru, online refill services, and a mobile app. At Bird Watson Drug, we take the time to get to know you, explain your medications, and answer questions you may have. At 1200 Main Street, our medical equipment store has a large selection of lift chairs, scooters, and other mobility equipment to meet your needs. Come in and check out our large selection of scrubs, including Wonder Wing, Carhartt, Grey's Anatomy, Certainty, Cherokee, and much more. The extremely comfortable clogs are great for people who are on their feet all day and made here in America. Bird Watson also has a large selection of compression stockings in a variety of colors and patterns. Stop by Bird Watson Pharmacy at 3401 Broadway or our medical equipment and scrubs location at 1200 Main Street. Bird Watson, specializing and expanding to provide patients and medical professionals with specialized service and expanded product offerings.
Streaming worldwide at WMIXSports.com. This is Mount Vernon Lady Rams basketball.
Lady Rams are 13-13, looking to stay above 500, at least in terms of closing out the regular season. Here tonight at Herrin Memorial Gymnasium is where we are. Chris Hugo with Danny Czerwinski alongside on 94.1 FM. Worldwide, we have video at WMIXSports.com. We hope you'll give us a follow on social media at WMIXSports on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and more. We're on SoundCloud and YouTube as well. Big matchup to close out the regular season for both of these two teams. They'll both go their separate ways. Herrin will feed into the Columbia Regional next week, where they will have Waterloo in one of the semifinals. Meanwhile, Lady Rams will have a play-in game at Salem. They'll have the Centralia Annies in a 7-8 matchup. Winner gets number one Salem on Tuesday. So these two teams kind of on opposite ends of the spectrum in terms of where they head for the postseason.
Well, and then usually past years they've been close to each other and or same regional, but with the addition of all the Ohio teams, you throw in subsectional play, and you throw in some Metro East schools, people get divided up and sent different ways. So this is a, as I'd like to say, dress rehearsal for these two teams in their final regular season tune-up.
Well, it is. Marion got past Herrin on Tuesday night, so the Lady Tigers coming off of probably what they feel is a surprise loss. Meanwhile, the Lady Rams coming off of a high-octane win on the road at Cahokia on Tuesday night, so that, too, opposite ends of the spectrum in terms of how they come in on this one. For both teams, not a lot of time to rest, not a lot of time to prep. Herrin coming off a disappointing loss, Lady Rams coming off a great win. Anything can happen here, however, on the road.
Anything can happen. Herrin is a good team, especially here at home and well-coached. And from the Ohio division, of course, Mount Vernon has played several teams from there this year. And again, for Mount Vernon, it's coming down here on the road again. It's been a tough part of the schedule, getting here and getting play, getting a win here in a place that a lot of teams don't come in and win.
That is no – well, there's no doubt about that, I guess, is what I'm trying to get at. Landers Collision Centers, Mount Vernon and Salem. Call 1-888-LANDERS. That's 1-888-LANDERS. We need to take another break. When we come back, we'll have more to talk about. The Mount Vernon Lady Rams and the Herrin Lady Tigers. It's senior night here from Memorial Gymnasium, as is the case on the final game of the regular season. This is Lady Rams basketball from WMIX Sports.
This tax season, use your refund where it will go the furthest. At Second Chance Auto, they go the distance to offer the best vehicles at the best prices. They're the buy here, pay here dealership that puts your needs first. So why spend more? Second Chance Auto will stretch every dollar of that hard-earned tax refund. Save hundreds, even thousands with their bank refinancing. A hassle-free buying experience and honest deals from honest people. Second Chance Auto, 36 years in business. They must be doing something right. Route 142 East in Mount Vernon.
A new occupational certificate is flying into Red Lake College in spring 2016. Learn to operate unmanned aircraft systems, better known as drones. Learn the next big thing in technology in as little as one semester. Classes conveniently held in the evenings. Drones are useful in many careers. Videographers can capture footage from the air. Farmers can check crops with precision. Investigators can examine crime scenes or assist with search and rescue. And the possibilities go on and on. Learn more at rlc.edu. Red Lake College, your journey starts
now. Valentine's Day is coming, which means love is in the air. If you've been hit by Cupid's arrow, don't forget to get a gift for your sweetheart. This is Chase Landers with Landers Towing and Collision Center. Why not let us offer you a unique idea for the love of your life? Give them a gift of a showroom clean vehicle with one of our premium details. Just call us to make an appointment for an easy surprise, or come, get a certificate, and we'll do the job when it's convenient for you. It's that easy. We promise they'll love you for it. If you are looking for Cupid, don't forget to watch out for Murray the Deer and his friends. The Mount Vernon and Salem locations have set aside 50 free deer whistles for anyone who is interested in coming and picking them up. Yes, we have 50 deer whistles to give away to the first customer to ask for them. We are here for you whenever you need us. Landers Towing and Collision Centers in Mount Vernon and Salem. Call 1-888-LANDERS. That's 1-888-LANDERS. And keep an eye out for Murray the Deer in Salem. I hear he plans to make an appearance at a few local businesses soon.
Back to Mount Vernon Lady Rams basketball, powered by Community First Bank of the Heartland.
WMIX FM, WMIXSports.com has your streaming video as we continue this Landers Collision Center's pregame show. Big or small, Landers fixes them all. Call 1-888-LANDERS. That's 1-888-LANDERS. With Danny Czerwinski, I'm Chris Hugo. A pleasure to be with you tonight from Memorial Gymnasium in Herrin, one of our favorite places to visit, at least mine.
It is a very nice stop on the way. We always like coming down here. Mike Mooney, the AD, and of course Jason Kearns, the football coach down here. Always take care of us. We enjoy coming to Herrin. Great facility. One of the gyms that we like, the styles of gym. The old bowl-style gym is what they have here.
Well, I'm a sucker for this style of gym. We got to come here this year for the Pyramid Plus tournament. And all in all, just love our trips down here to Williamson County, former conference stop for Mount Vernon up until about 23 years ago. So there you go. There's a little bit of history in terms of this gymnasium. We told you where both of these two teams head for the postseason, 1A and 2A regional title games. Are tonight. 3A and 4A girls regionals will start next week. We get to know who the 1A and 2A boys teams, where they will go, who they will play tomorrow. We have reached that point of the season. Well, we start to find out who goes where.
Find that out tomorrow. I mean, it's that time of year where you find out different things for all the basketball stuff, and then you find out maybe the spring stuff. Baseball and softball will be coming out any time as far as who will host. So you have that going on. You run into nights like this where you have senior night going on. Herrin does it during the warm-ups. They'll stop the clock with five to go. They honor the four seniors they have on the team, and then they'll continue the clock, and we'll start the game relatively on time, if not a little bit early compared to most nights.
No doubt about it. They played seven-minute JV quarters here tonight. That shortens up the JV contest just a little bit.
You know, if they would move the JV game start times to 6 o'clock and play seven-minute JV quarters like they did back when, well, wouldn't that be nice? That should be the most sensible way to do it, wouldn't you think?
It would be. Speaking of sensible and ways to do things, the Mount Vernon Township High School Athletic Office announced tonight that they will start pre-selling tickets for the final game at Chagnon. That's a Rams Orphans game. They will start pre-selling on Monday, February the 15th. That is this Monday at 4 p.m. Tickets, of course, will be sold in Chagnon, and they will only be sold to Jefferson County residents, and there will be a limit of 4 tickets per person. High school students can now purchase tickets on Tuesday the 16th, beginning at 8 o'clock. However, only one ticket per student. That is for the final game at Chagnon Gymnasium on February the 19th. Tickets on sale for Jefferson County residents only. Starting on Monday at 4, you can buy 4 tickets. For students, it'll be Tuesday at 8. That is in the morning. And that'll be one ticket per student. Still some tickets available for the Mount Vernon Township High School Hall of Fame. That'll be on Saturday, 4:45. The doors open. They believe they start serving at 5:30. You can get tickets at One Stop Flooring America, the 300 block of South 10th Street in Mount Vernon. Find out more details from Larry Lyday or any Hall of Fame committee member. Also, we have found out that the Rams baseball team selling tickets to a Cardinals game at Busch Stadium against the A's. I'll have to get the date for you. I don't have it on
May
hand.
May 14th,
right?
8 o'clock Saturday night.
That is when they will play Muskuta. But they will have, I believe, box seats for a Cardinals-A's game that they have to sell, I believe, so many of. So they can play at Busch Stadium. So that'll be a big honor for the Mount Vernon Rams, of course. Their baseball season getting started with practice just a couple weeks from now, and then season will be here before you know it. This is your Landers Collision Center's pregame show. Big or small, Landers fixes them all. Call 1-888-LANDERS. That's 1-888-LANDERS. And it's a busy night for Jefferson County. Involved teams tonight on the girls' side as far as 1A and 2A regionals.
Yeah.
We have three county teams in a regional title game tonight.
Well, and it's all pretty good at the half. 2A regional final, SVW leads Johnston City 28-25. That's at Cesar. At Steelville at the half, Christopher leads Weber 29-28. And then in 1A, also at ZR, it is Woodlawn 19, Gallatin County 18. So all of our showcase teams are in a battle trying to make it to next week to Goreville for the 1A teams and Trico for Cesar, Valera, Waltonville.
You know what's even better? They all win. They all play Monday night. So do the Mount Vernon Lady Rams at Salem. So hoping for four Jefferson County teams to make it into Monday night. We have one guaranteed, obviously, as the Lady Rams will open up regional play. But a big one tonight, a team that the Lady Rams have struggled with, are these Herrin Lady Tigers. Beat them at Chagnon on a December Thursday. Came in here to Herrin for a regional in February, and Herrin pretty well had their way. Since then, Lady Rams have struggled with this quality river-to-river Ohio program.
Yeah, and it's a tough deal. And that's the thing. When you run into the Ohio division, the Benton Rangerettes, Harrisburg Lady Bulldogs, who, by the way, will be on the Mount Vernon schedule starting next year. Herrin is already on the schedule. You play Massac in a couple tournaments. You'd love to see Frankfort and Murphy on there as well. But all these schools in the Ohio division are well-coached. By the time they get through the 10-game grind of the Ohio division playing each other, it's a tough team to go against. And Herrin is no doubt. They probably had a letdown the other night against Marion a little bit, thinking ahead. And, of course, they're going to want to come out here the bittersweet night that it is senior night and try to get a win for these seniors in their final trip on the floor.
Well, no doubt. Final game for Herrin here at Memorial Gymnasium. Final game of the regular season for both of these two teams. Lady Rams had their final game from Chagnon in the program's history last Thursday night. They beat the Marion Lady Wildcats. Their winning streak continued on Tuesday on the road at Cahokia with a nice win over the Lady Comanches. That was a 63-56 final. They've at least assured themselves with a win tonight of finishing the regular season game over 500 and would finish it no worse than 500 should they have an untimely disappointment on Monday night in the regional. Looks like we're going to go ahead and honor America from Memorial Gymnasium. When we come back, we'll have your Ford Square King City Chrysler starting lineups here on Senior Night in Williamson County. This is Lady Rams basketball from WMIX Sports. Bye.
Mount Vernon Township High School Sports Hall of Fame inducts the class of 2016 on Saturday, February 13th at Chagnon Gymnasium. Rams heroes being honored include Chad Hammonds, Tommy Hayes, Lindsey Wagner, J.W. Sanders, Jason Brooks, Jerry Wilson, and friend of the Rams, John Rackaway. Relive the memories of the 1908-09 and 1991-92 Rams basketball teams, as well as the 2001 girls cross-country team. Tickets are available at One Stop Flooring America at 318 South 10th Street in Mount Vernon. Doors will open at 4:45 with dinner at 5:30. See you Saturday, February 13th at Chagnon.
Chrysler is celebrating President's Day all month long. Hi, Roy Schmidt of the King City Chrysler Center. During the month of February, receive additional bonus cash on several models. Excluding Jeep Wrangler, all Jeep brands, you will receive an additional $500 bonus cash. The family-friendly Chrysler Town & Country and the sporty fun-to-drive Chrysler 200 will get you an additional $1,000 in President's Day bonus cash. The affordable, always convenient Dodge Grand Caravan also grabs you an additional savings of $1,000 for President's Day. President's bonus cash is added to all other current incentives. Don't delay. Stop in and start saving today right here at King City Chrysler Center, 1603 Broadway in Mount Vernon, or call us at 618-242-6600 or shop online at kingcitychrysler.com.
Hi, Eric Latte for One Stop Flooring America. I want to personally invite everyone to stop by our booth at this year's Mount Vernon Home Show. Meet our award-winning staff and let them show you all the latest styles and trends in flooring. Also, make sure you register for all of the great home show specials and giveaways, including Cardinal tickets and a pair of Luke Bryan tickets. All of the fun is at One Stop Flooring America's booth this Saturday and Sunday at the Mount Vernon Home Show. One Stop Flooring America, 318 South 10th Street, Mount Vernon. 242-5712.
Watch the Lady Rams online at WMIXSports.com. Powered by Red Lake College.
WMIX FM, WMIXSports.com with streaming video tonight of the Mount Vernon Lady Rams and the Herrin Lady Tigers. I'm Chris Hugo. Danny Czerwinski is alongside as we need to meet your Ford Square starting lineup. Ford Square of Mount Vernon. Log on to FordSquare.com to see all their new Fords, as well as pre-owned inventory, or Lincoln Square of Mount Vernon.com to see their new Lincoln assortment. The Lady Rams, coached by Jeff Lawnen, 00 Jasmine Hawkins, number 2 Lauren Heinzman, number 5 Peyton Hayes, number 12 Kate Bashu, and number 35 Madeline Keel getting the starts tonight for Jeff Lawnen as we prepare to meet the Herrin Lady Tigers, coached by Bill Green. King City Chrysler Center is home of Express Lane, Fast Oil Changes, and more. Find them at 1603 Broadway in Mount Vernon, or if you need to have something done, maybe more than just an oil change, a couple of things. Maybe you need to drop your car off, schedule your service appointments online at kingcitychryslercenter.com. They'll start four seniors tonight on senior night. Number 10, Abunia Moore. Number 14, Brooke Jarrell. Number 15, Michaela Smothers. Number 30, Madison LaQuat. And number 40, Braylon Mack. For Bill Green's Lady Tigers, they head to Columbia to play Waterloo next week, I believe on Wednesday night in a semifinal. Lady Rams will head to Salem on Monday at 6 o'clock. 5:45 will be your pregame as they tangle with the Centralia Annies. 6 o'clock will be the tip in that one. You can watch it online at WMIXSports.com. It'll be right here on the FM as it'll be LaQuat left to right for the Tigers. It'll be Hawkins right to left for the Lady Rams. They're away blacks, orange trim, orange numerics trimmed in white. Tip will be controlled in the backcourt by the Lady Tigers. Home whites, orange trim, black numerics trimmed in orange. This will be Smothers across the timeline. Up top of the key, throws off left wing for Moore. Looks inside, going to have to settle up top for Jarrell. 7:47 to go in the first, just underway from Williams County, and we'll have a foul. They tried to close down the passing lane, and Peyton Hayes picks up the foul, the first on the team.
Reaching over the defender, over the shoulder, will not work. Got a foul just 99.9% of the time at this level.
Inbound for the Tigers will come from underneath their basket. Good play in the post. They're able to find Berlin Mack, and she makes it a 2-0 ball game, putting Herrin on top early.
And Herrin will go zone here to start with. 2-3, it looks like.
Right wing, that is Bashu. Now back to Heinzman. 7:24 left in the first quarter, 2-0 Herrin on top. Looking to shake off a little disappointment from Thursday. As they lost to, or excuse me, Tuesday when they lost to Marion. Off of the turnover into the front court. This will be the Lady Tigers right side. That is Gerald with the basketball. Picked up her pivot, travels with it. It'll be a turnover on Herrin.
Little nerves early on. good game for both teams on the schedule. Just happens to be senior night, and there'll be some nerves from the orange and white, the home team.
7:05 to go in the first. 2-0 Herrin on top. Lady Rams with the basketball. This is Heinzman. Looking into the elbow. Nice bounce past the wing. Bashu into the corner for Hawk, and she had 27 on the road against Cahokia. 6:53 to go in the first. Still a 2-0 ball game. Herrin on top. If you pick orange and black in this one, your odds actually aren't very good because both teams are orange and black. 6:43 to go in the first. 2-0 to score. Lady Rams trailing, but with the basketball, slowed things down here to start off this first quarter. Good ball fake by Heisman inside the free throw line. Going to lose it. Tipped into the corner for Hawkins. That looks like a quick reach foul there on Herrin. It'll be on Berlon Mack. Community First Bank of the Heartland, the official voice of high school sports here on WMIX. Find them at Mountford and Dix, Woodlawn and Ina. And they remind you, if your bank has changed names again, it's not you, it's them. Good shot by Keel inside the free throw line is no good. Rebound will go to the Lady Tigers into the front court. This is Smothers looking inside. Good lob pass. It'll be stolen away, but it's saved right to the Tigers. Posting up is Mack. Nope. Rebound will go to Herrin, it looks like.
Fatal mistake. The Lady Rams had the basketball, and they threw it in right underneath the basket. And that's not what you got to do when you throw it right underneath your opponent's basket.
Second foul on the Lady Rams. This will be the first on Lauren Heinzman. And to the line goes Madison LaQuad. She'll make the first. She'll have another. 3-0 Herrin on top here early with 6:13 to go in this opening quarter. Oh, man. Second one is on the way. It's good. That'll make it 4-0.
Supper was too good, eh?
Carb overload.
Could be.
I believe when it's all said and done. 6:07 to play in the first. Nice bounce pass to Hayes. She'll throw it back to Heisman. Left wing off of the sideline for Peyton. Looking underneath for Hawkins inside the block. A tough play against Mack. Rebound to Kate. She'll miss it. So after an offensive rebound, nothing there. And now Herrin will go the other way with it. With it up top, Smothers. 5:49 to go in the first. 4-0 is the Lady Tiger lead. Gerald off of the right wing against Hawkins. Throws it at the feet of LaQuat. She'll pick it up. And we'll have a reach as she's bailed out by Madeline Keel. Her first, team's third.
Lady Rams doing a lot of reaching tonight. Trying to reach across, reach over, reach around. Just doesn't work that way.
Rick and Mount Gerald. She wants a three from the right wing, and it's good.
Shutout right now being pitched by Herrin. Mount Vernon needs to get themselves back into this. That big road win at Cahokia may have set them back a bit.
Maybe. 7-0. Tigers on top. Lady Rams with the basketball. Heinzman up top wants an answer. From the top, no good. Rebound will be tipped away. So Lady Rams ice cold to start here from the field. Third defensive rebound of the night for the Tigers, and now Herrin playing quickly in the front court, but that'll be a foul on a reach, and it'll be the Lady Rams' fourth. Yikes.
Lady Rams need to start moving their feet a little bit. Too much reaching into the cookie jar, and they're getting caught.
Quick inbound to Mack. Shot was blocked from behind. Rebound to the Tigers. Chased down left side. Now a three on the way. It's going to be short. Hayes will get the rebound. We have the Smothers three try. Now one of two from three-point land of the Tigers. 7-0 the score. Herrin on top. 5 minutes to play in the first. Off of the far sideline. Good ball fake by Hawkins. Pulls up off the baseline. It's no good. Rebound will go to Herrin. They're out rebounding the Lady Rams to start. As Smothers across the timeline. Dribbles top. Looks left wing. Now trying to find the post. Mack, a nice turnaround. Uses the glass.
Wow.
She has four.
All Herrin so far. Timeout, Jeff Lonin.
Timeouts presented by Purcell Tire and Service Center at 1212 Broadway in Mountford, and they treat every car like it's their grandma's car. And they love their grandmas at Purcell Tire and Service Center. 4:39 to go in the first. 9-0. That's 9-0. Herrin on top of your Lady Rams here on the road tonight at Memorial Gymnasium, and not quite the start I think the Lady Rams had envisioned.
No, and definitely not off the momentum they had on that big road win Tuesday at Cahokia. They are struggling to find the offense here, needless to say, down 9-0 to start.
0-5 unofficially from the field with just one offensive rebound here in the early going. 4:39 remains in the first, 9-0 score. JV score. Lady Rams finish off their season with a 32-26 win. Come from behind fashion over the Tigers. Pretty good effort on the road tonight for the junior varsity after a tough loss at Cahokia. 4:36 to play in the first. Into the front court goes Heinzman looking off to the right wing, but shoot. Now Hawk wants a three, dials one up. It's good.
All right, there we go. Lids off the basket.
Cuts it into a third. It's 9-3 with 4:25 left in the first. Video streaming presented by Renlake College. Log on to rlc.edu. So yeah, you can save thousands on your college education. Chase down right corner. That was Gerald. Now back near the right circle. Right of the circle for Smothers. Off to the sideline for Moore. Back to the top. Laquat could be stolen away. It's a foot race. Recovered by Heinzman. Off the turnover. She'll dribble all the way down. And we have a foul.
That looks like a foul. The lazy mechanic. It's that time of year. You called and blown the whistles all winter long. And referees get tired as well.
Box set for the Lady Rams, right at the bucket on the baseline. It'll be Hayes in the Heinzman short corner. Now left wing Vishu off of a screen. Peyton's three will be blocked. No call, and then the rebound off of a knee out of bounds. It'll go with Herrin. Talked about Herrin Lake College a second ago. We appreciate their efforts to stream the Southern Illinois Junior High School Athletic Association Class S, M, and L finals. Going to see some of the local teams down there that'll become your future high school stars on WMIX. Left side for Herrin. That's Gerald with a right-hand dribble. Smothers off the deep left wing. Now dribbling off to the free throw line. Inside to Max. She'll use the glass again. She has six in the quarter. It's 11-3, Herrin. Hot start for the Tigers. Heinz with a crossover dribble.
Senior night.
Left wing for Hayes. Back to Heinz, but she's deep with 3:29 left. Hayes wants a three. Looks good. Nope. Off the iron. Rebound and put back. Maybe a three-point play now for Kate Bashu. She got it off the window, off of the stick back. Pretty good effort by the Lady Rams now. 3:23 left in the first. A chance to cut it to possibly five. It's 11-5 right now.
Well, I like to see Lady Rams starting to wake up a little bit. Get things going. In the lineup for Herrin, number
23, Anna Gradich. So Gradich will check in for Mack, who has her second foul. 3:23 left in the first quarter. 11-5 score, up six for the Tigers. Lady Rams looking to cut it to five as Bashu will leave the free throw short. Rebound to go to Herrin. Six defensive boards. They've been crashing the glass here in the first. And out of the front court, Smothers to Jarrell. Another three on the way. No good this time. Rebound to go to the back door for Hayes. 3:09 left in the opening quarter. We'll look for a 20 Wilt State Farm player of the game. Is it Heinzman with this three? No. It'll sail off into the left corner. Recovered by Kate almost, but lost it out of bounds. 20 Wilt, your State Farm agent in Mount Vernon. Find him online at tonywilt.com. Get to a better state with State Farm. We'll have our player of the game. Our three stars of the game, as a matter of fact, coming up in our postgame show. Across the timeline right, this is Jarrell. Runs into the defender, Heinzman. Now bounces a pass into the paint. Laquat on the turnaround is no good. Rebound will be tipped out, and it'll go with the Lady Rams.
Well, trying to find their footing a little bit. Mount Vernon's doing a little bit better job doing that here since the timeout.
2:40 to play in the first. Heinzman across the timeline. Vishu to the left. Heinzman will swing it around to the sideline for Hayes. Now back to Heinzman. Free throw line keel. Tips it out to the right wing. Three on the way by Kate is good. Another tray for the Lady Rams.
Splash.
Cuts it to three.
Yeah. Mount Vernon moving the ball very well around the perimeter. Back to within three. Jeff lining up, cheering on the troops.
Gerald will feed Laquat on the right block. Turnaround. Her shot's blocked. Rebound will go to the Lady Rams. They have three defensive rebounds over the past minute and a half. Into the front court, down three, 2:07 to go in the first. To tie it, it's Hawkins, no good off the back of the iron. Rebound, Hayes will tip it in the corner for Bashu. Maybe some second chance points. As off of the right comes Heisman, good bounce pass to Hawk. She's fouled on her way to the hoop. To the line will go Jasmine Hawkins as a foul is called with a minute 56 to go in the first.
That's what I've heard. Mount Vernon's gained their footing a little bit in this one. A lot better.
Save Hawkins. Make a free throw or two here with a minute 56 to go. We're in the first quarter from Herrin of girls basketball. The Lady Rams and the Lady Tigers. It's a three-point game. As Hawks first is good, she'll have another. Four in the quarter for Jasmine. Again, who's coming off of a 27-point effort on the road at Cahokia on Tuesday. We'll see if she can get her fourth point of the night right here. Second one's in route. It's good. One-point game brewing here in Memorial Gym. It's 11-10. Lady Rams are back within one. Less than 2 minutes to play in the first quarter. Full court here for the Lady Rams. It's coming up the left side as Smothers looking to go to the corner. Now throws into the paint. They'll kick it right back out. Jarrell with it up top. Three on the way is no good. Rebound underneath Laquat. Sticks it up. No good. Third time a charm. Laquat battling for the rebound. We'll have a jump ball.
Jump ball with all possession Rams.
Mount Vernon has woke up a little bit in this one after being down 9-0.
9-0 to 9-3, then I think 11-5, if memory serves. Either way, they're down one now as Hayes has it off to the sideline, back to the left wing. That's right in front of us for Heisman. Now to the sideline for Peyton, has Hawkins in the paint. Instead goes to Heisman. Right wing for Bashu now to the corner. This is Hawkins with the basketball, back to the right wing. They'll go to the elbow, and now they'll reverse it around left side. Hayes with it off of the pass from Heisman, back to Heisman on a bounce. Free throw line, Keel kicks it out. Hawkins coming around right, nothing there. Down one with 1:04 left in the first. They'll keep it around the perimeter right now, just can't find any movement inside. Keel kicks out. 18-footer on the way. Hawk is good. Lady Rams are first lead of the night.
Inside, outside versus that zone. That's what's going on.
And now into the right corner, Jarrell. Down one, her Tigers with 43 seconds left in the first. Left wing, this is Crowditch. Left corner, baseline, smothers up top, Jarrell. Short corner, this is going to go Crowditch. Her jumper is blocked, but a foul. That'll be on Keel.
Oh, my. Yep. Outside trail official called that. That's overcalling the zone on his look. Not supposed to call that far down the lane there.
Now at the line, Groutage to shoot two to try to tie and take the lead for Herrin. Her first one is in and out. So the best she can do is tie with 33.2 seconds left to go on the first. Scoreboard updates tonight presented by Bird Watson Home Medical. They have a great assortment of Asics and clogs. Don't sacrifice looks for comfort. You can have both at Bird Watson, 1200 Main in Mount Vernon. They miss both.
Just watching the official there. He kind of crowded up to the Lady Rams bench. Then when Jeff Lonan walked down toward the baseline, the referee started to walk away. It's kind of like he was looking to do something.
Lady Rams may be looking for the final shot. 16 seconds left here in the first half. 12-11, the Mountford lead. 10 seconds left. Heisman at the circle. Right-hand dribble switches left. Bounces it to Hayes off of the wing. Skip pass over to Heisman. Lost it, recovered. Back up top with four. Head faked by Hayes. Three at the buzzer is no good. And that is how our first quarter will end. 12-11, Mount Vernon on top after one. This is Lady Rams basketball, powered by Community First Bank.
Ever feel like you're paying your bank to be there for you? Hi, I'm Debbie Ashby with Community First Bank, and we believe being chosen as your financial partner is a privilege. That's why we still offer free checking with free debit cards and free online banking and bill pay for your convenience. No hassles, no hoops to jump through, just your local hometown bank being there for you. Stop by one of our five Jefferson County locations today to see the Community First difference and let us welcome you back to personal banking. Community First Bank with locations in Mount Vernon, Woodlawn, Dixon, Ina. Member FDIC.
Orthopedic Center of Southern Illinois is pleased to welcome Dr. Wendell Becton, a sports medicine expert who's outstanding in his field. Dr. Becton specializes in non-surgical primary care orthopedics, sports medicine, and rehabilitation, and was also a team physician for the St. Louis Cardinals. Best of all, his experience in caring for athletes and other active patients is now available to you at the Orthopedic Center of Southern Illinois. Visit online at orthocenter-si.com or call 242-3778. Orthopedic Center of Southern Illinois. Discover the difference.
This is Mount Vernon Lady Rams basketball, powered by Community First Bank of
Ohio. WMIX FM, WMIXSports.com. Chris Hugo with Danny Czerwinski alongside. Here from Memorial Gymnasium, 12-11 is your score. As right now, Lady Rams with the basketball to start. They lead it by one here in the second quarter as we begin. Up top, this is Bashu looking off to the right wing. Heisman sets up for a three. It's no good. Rebound will be tipped away. The taller Herrin Timber recovers. And that'll be another rebound for them in their 12th of the game. 7:39 to go in the half. Short corner on the right. Herrin with the basketball. Cannot see. That is Madison Russell. Looks inside. Stolen away. Third turnover of the night for Herrin. And now the Lady Rams with the advantage into the front court. Up top, this is going to be Heisman. Bounce pass to the free throw line. Keel. Oh. Back outside for Bashu, who throws underneath for Hawkins, who misses the shot, but will go to the line to shoot two.
Yeah. Had a shot at it. Got hammered, but Mount Vernon playing much better here since the start of this game.
7:20 left to go here in the first half, the first free throw of this set is good from Jasmine Hawkins. It's 13-11. Oh. missed the second. So 1-2 that trip. 13-11 Lady Rams on top. 7-16 to play in the first half. Russell out of the left corner, looks inside. Turnaround coming for Groutage is in and out. Rebound will go to the Lady Rams.
Herrin started out house of fire early and can't get anything going offensively now.
We'll see if it's problematic the rest of the way as the Lady Rams look to expand this lead. Right wing for Kate. Bushu with a right-hand dribble. Bounce pass between the circles for Heinzman with 6:50 left. Lead as much as they can get here in this second quarter is off to the right corner. That is going to be Hayes. Looks back to the wing for Bushu. Free throw line. Don't make it the elbow. Kick out coming Hayes. She needs a basket. Bam. She knocks this one down.
Yep. Mount Vernon has found the shooting touch here late first, early second. Nice little lead now by Mount Vernon, up by five.
As now into the right corner, Russell wants a three. It's good. A little rainbow shot from the right corner for Madison Russell. That'll change things in a hurry. Cuts it to a possession, 16-14 as they had an answer for the three ball. Right of the circle, this is Hawking. Make that Heinzman. Throwing off to the right side for Hayes with 6:07 to play in the first half. 16-14, the Lady Ram lead. Skip pass to Hawk. Good ball fake as she tries to go on the defender. Throws back up top for Heinzman. Good no-looker to Kate. Back in the left corner for Hawk. Now to Kate off of the wing. Tipped away. It'll be top of the key. And now to the right side for Peyton Hayes. Had a big three a moment ago, but quickly answered by Russell. And now Heinzman thought about one. Right elbow. They'll kick it back out. Hayes, is she 2 of 2 in the quarter? Ooh. Yes, she is.
Wow. 19-14. She's found her stroke in the last couple of weeks from downtown. It's worked out very well, obviously.
Start off a little cold, but it's heating up here in the second quarter. Another rainbow shot by Russell. This time no good. Rebound and put back not there. But two coming from the line for Herrin.
Well, it's Cesar Valier is up 4 at the end of 3. Woodlawn is up. That was an update. That was 3 minutes ago. 3 minutes left in the game. Woodlawn is up 6. And Weber Township down 6. So right now, Showcase teams 2 out of 3 are winning. Weber trails 32-26 into 3. Woodlawn's up 34-28 with 3 minutes to go in the game. Sessor's up 7 at the end of 3.
Free throws no good that time for Herrin. 5:25 left to go in the first half here. 19-14, the Lady Ram lead. Bushu off of the deep right wing, now to the circle for Heinzman. Works it to the free throw line. Keel out bodied through to the outside for Hawkins. Now to Heinzman. Big three if it goes. Yes. Huge.
Woo. Mount Vernon is found it all right now.
Up 8, 22-14, 5:05 to play in the half. Winning Edge is one of our great booster sponsors. They have plenty of Rams apparel, 212 South 9th, including the new logo as Madison Russell dials up a corner three. It's no good. Rebound Laquat puts it up. No good. And a foul. Woof. Of course, you can order your Rams gear online at store.winningedgeusa.com.
Christopher now up 46-37 over Weber Township with about 5 minutes to go. Now we got a congregation of officials. They don't know who to call the foul on. So this is where Jeff Lawton's head could pop off if they do something silly.
Well, they're on their feet all day, at least all game. And if you're on your feet all day in the medical field, visit Bird Watson, 1200 Main Street in Mount Vernon. They have a large assortment of Asics and clogs, sure to make your feet love you. You don't have to sacrifice looks for comforts. Find them on Facebook as Laquat makes a free throw.
Jeff Lonnan talking with the official now, one closest to him. Casual conversation.
And second one's good. So 2 of 2 that time. Makes it a 6-point game. 22-16. Ryan checked in. She has the basketball. Uh-oh, almost thrown away by Mount Vernon. It's going to plinko around. Pitter-patter of feet everywhere. And on the jump ball to go with Herrin. Lady Ram turnover.
Uh-oh, detention's over.
4:43 left to go in the half. 22-16 here. It's a 6-point ball game.
Got to be impressed with Mount Vernon's mental aspect here, getting down 9-0 and turning it into a 6-point lead. Now make that 4.
As Laquat rolls off of the block and finds another post up, she has 6 of the 18. Lady Rams lead down to 4.
Cesar now up 11, 50-39.
They'll feed Hawkins off of the low post. She'll come out into the corner off the dribble, finds Ryan. Kindle the free throw line, Keel. It'll be thrown away almost by the Lady Rams. Passing lane, that was tipped away And they'll reset off of the sideline on the opposite side of the benches with 4:15 left here in the second quarter. Good bounce pass into Ryan. She'll step top of the key. Looks off into the corner, and that pass will go out of bounds if not tipped away by Madison Russell. Turnover Mount Vernon. And into the front court, big opportunity for the Herrin Tigers. This is Smothers. Left of the circle, into the corner for Russell. Gets it right back off of the wing with 3:57 to play in the half. Streaming presented by Herrin Lake College as a three is short by Russell. Rebound, Lady Rams.
Uh-oh. Miss Ryan got away with a little shove with the offhand.
As now, Ryan has it back up top from Hayes. She'll dribble through traffic, throws in the corner for Hawkins. Ball fake. Passing lanes aren't there. Lady Rams unaware of that, and they turn the ball over again. Their third of the quarter with a 30-32 left to go. Herrin Lake College can save you thousands on your college education. Log on to rlc.edu to find out how. As Madison Russell knocks down another tray. No hand in her face, makes it 22-21 with 3:20 left in the half. Ryan up top will be pushed from behind. And don't know how to really describe what we're seeing right now. 3:16 left in the half. It's a one-point game, 22-21. And Lady Rams will inbound from side to bounce. Into the corner for Hayes, back to Hawk on the right wing. 3:13 to play in the second quarter. Back from Keel to Hayes. Left-hand dribble for Payton. Looking for a skip pass. Nope, settles for no passing lanes. Lady Rams almost threw it away again. Herrin, however, can't catch up to the loose basketball. So Lady Rams will inbound in front of the scorer's table as they've met a little bit of foul trouble here in the first half. We'll see George check in for Kendall Ryan.
A little sloppy here.
3:03 to go in the half, 22-21. Lady Rams hanging on. They were up, I believe, 8 a moment ago. 7-0 run by Herrin. As now Keel troubles with the basketball. Finds George trying to get past the defender more. And now throws one out of bounds off of the defender. Smothers, and Lady Rams will inbound again. With 2:48 left to go in the first half, 22-21 is the Mount Vernon lead. Doesn't appear safe at the moment as right wings. George back up to the top. Good short corner pass. Hayes from Bashu. Back to Hawkins. Now near the top of the key. Keel. Three on the way by Kate. No good. Rebound, though, by Hawkins. She's bumped from behind.
Good work.
She'll go to the line.
Jasmine's in there working hard. I mean, she doesn't have a lot of points to show for it, but boy, she's done a great job getting in there and getting rebounds. Sesser is up 56-40 with 2:54 to go in their game. Woodlawn leads 38-30 with just over a minute to go in their game.
First free throw, no good for Hawkins. 2:35 to play in the first half, 22-21. Is the Lady Ram lead here. They're up 8 just a moment ago. Scoreboard updates presented by Bird Watson Home Medical, 1200 Main Street, Mount Vernon.
Bree Central beat Altaw 47-29 in a 2A regional final.
Hawkins makes 1-2 at the line, makes the back end to extend the lead to 23-21. So a two-point game at Memorial Gymnasium as Bill Green wants the timeout, presented by Purcell Tire and Service Center at 1212 Broadway in Mount Vernon. Of course, don't foul out this season. Make sure you check those tires. Before heading out on your next road trip, they'll check them for free at Purcell Tire and Service Center, 1212 Broadway in Mount Vernon. We have 2:35 left to go in the first half. We're on the Twitterverse at WMIX Sports. Find us on Facebook and Instagram as well.
Yep, so regional finals tonight going on in a lot of places. A lot of teams are going to carry some hardware home.
2:30 left to go in the half, 23-21 ball game. With it up top, Smothers for the Herrin Tigers. They trail by two, looking to make a move, almost stripped away it is. It's stolen by the Lady Rams. It'll be a Hawkins on a break layup, left hand no good, but to the line to shoot two. We'll go Jasmine.
Cessa Valera now at 58-40, 2:45 to go, and Weber has crawled back to within four, 46-42.
At the free throw line is Hawkins. Her first free throw is no good. She'll have another, trying to extend it to a three-point lead with 2:18 left in the first half.
So Cesar Valera-Waltonville hangs on. They'll get Breeze Central at Trico.
Second one, good. Three-point game, 24-21. with 2:17 left to go here in the half. Across the timeline, this is Smothers dribbling down the middle to the top of the key. Now right wing. Steps back for a long two and banks it in.
Bang.
They're going to count it as a three.
Yep.
I didn't see it.
I thought she was behind inside the two-point line.
But it ties it at 24. Lady Rams are up eight a moment ago. Now out of the right. Right. Oh, my. Off of the right elbow, thrown out of bounds. Another turnover from Mount Vernon. Five turnovers in the quarter unofficially with 1:55 left. Tied at 24. Herrin with the basketball, Smothers into the front court. Now dribbles to the free throw line, throws off right elbow. That was Groutage, and now able to hand off to Deaton. Inside, ooh, Groutage off the glass. Herrin back on top, 26-24. Playing just a little bit better here in the second quarter than the Lady Rams. They're in a bit of foul trouble, you see, as the wing, that is Hawkins. Elbow jumper, bang.
Why not?
Nice.
Everybody can use that big square glass thing.
Giel ties it at 26 with a minute 19 to play in the second quarter. We'll look for Tony Wilt, State Farm Stars of the Game in this one. Find Tony in your neighborhood in that white State Farm Jeep, or look online at TonyWilt.com. Get to a better state with State Farm. Right elbow, this is Groutage. Now she's going to find Deaton trying to get to the basket. Travels with the basketball. Third turnover of the quarter for Herrin. And now tied at 26 with a minute 3 left to go in the first half. Lady Rams basketball, length of the floor. Across the timeline, Kate. Nice little bounce pass. Two Hawks, skips it out to George. Wide open is Hayes. Corner three on the way. Peyton, good.
Woo! 4 for 4. They like this tile of gym.
As now up top, this will be Smothers. Around under the baseline, meets Keel. Wild shot, no good. Rebound will be tipped away by the Lady Rams. Can't hang on, it would seem. So Herrin will retain possession. 35.5 seconds left. Second quarter, 29-26 Mount Vernon. Long pass to Moore up top. Right sideline for Russell. This is Madison Russell. Now to the top for Moore. Skips a pass into the corner for Deaton. Thought about it. Now Smothers left wing with 25 seconds. All alone underneath. Nobody there to watch Moore. She has two. It's 29-28. Lady Rams by one with 18 seconds left to go in the half. Right corner now, or should say right sideline for Hawk. Busher with it off of the right wing. Now looking left side of the circle for George. Has to get it right back from Hayes, and then it's thrown away. But it's tipped out of bounds by Herrin with 4.7 seconds left here in the second. So Heinzman will check in. She'll throw in from near the scorer's table. Jeff Lana wants a timeout to talk it over. This timeout presented by Purcell Tire and Service Center in Malvern. And they have that new Hunter Quick Check system. All in less than 5 minutes and at no charge. They check tire tread depths, charging, diagnostics, you name it. Purcell Tire and Service Center, 1212 Broadway in the King City. Proud supporters of the Mount Vernon Rams. It's 29-28. Lady Rams are up one here with about 4.7 seconds left, and they'll have the basketball out of the timeout. Need to come up with a play here of some sort.
Final score, Woodlawn wins tonight, 43-30 over Gallatin County. So Woodlawn advances to the 1A sectional, or 1A, yeah, 1A sectional at Goreville Monday. Karma, based on our restaurant tonight.
Oh, yeah. Let's try to figure that out. Quick inbound with four. It'll be Heinzman to the basket. At the buzzer, left it short, and won't get another try. So Lady Rams come up empty on that possession. And here at the half, it is the Mount Vernon Lady Rams 29, the Herrin Lady Tigers 28. We'll come back. We'll talk it over on your Second Chance Auto halftime show. This is Lady Rams basketball from WMIX Sports.
I'm meeting Wildest Dave Bowers. We'll look at your next ride weather. It'll turn cloudy this evening, then a bit of snow from late evening on, leaving a coating to an inch by morning, a low 20. Tomorrow, cloudy through midday, and then breaks the sun later in the afternoon, a high 36. Partly cloudy and frigid tomorrow night, a low 7. Saturday, lots of sunshine, quite cold, a high 23, and then we'll see some snow later Saturday night through Sunday. Mitch Redweather from WMIX, Mount Vernon, Illinois.
Mount Vernon Township High School Sports Hall of Fame inductee class of 2016 on Saturday, February 13th at Chagnon Gymnasium. Rams heroes being honored include Chad Hammonds, Tommy Hayes, Lindsey Wagner, J.W. Sanders, Jason Brooks, Jerry Wilson, and friend of the Rams, John Rackaway. Relive the memories of the 1908, 09, and 1991-92 Rams basketball teams, as well as the 2001 girls cross-country team. Tickets are available at One Stop Flooring America at 318 South 10th Street in Mount Vernon. Doors will open at 4:45, with dinner at 5:30. See you Saturday, February 13th at Chagnon.
Did your bank recently make changes or add fees to your checking account? Free yourself from fees with a free checking account from People's National Bank. A Visa check card, online banking, bill pay, mobile banking, mobile deposit, and access to over 20,000 ATMs are some of the added conveniences you get with your free checking account at People's National Bank. Stop by your local People's National Bank today or visit www.peoplesnationalbank.com for details on how to get your free checking account. People's National Bank, member FDIC. Non-usage and wireless carrier fees may apply.
This tax season, use your refund where it will go the furthest. At Second Chance Auto, they go the distance to offer the best vehicles at the best prices. They're the buy here, pay here dealership that puts your needs first. So why spend more? Second Chance Auto will stretch every dollar of that hard-earned tax refund. Save hundreds, even thousands with their bank rate financing. A hassle-free buying experience and honest deals from honest people. Second Chance Auto, 36 years in business. They must be doing something right. Mount 142 East in Mount Vernon.
This is Mount Vernon Lady Rams basketball from WMIX Sports. The Second Chance Auto halftime show starts now.
WMIX FM, WMIXSports.com here at the half in Herrin. The Lady Rams lead the Tigers 29-28. With Danny Czerwinski, I'm Chris Hugo for your Second Chance Auto halftime show. Second Chance Auto, Route 142 East in Mount Vernon. Proud supporters of the Mount Vernon Rams, making your tax dollars go further for over 36 years at Second Chance Auto. We'll make them go further, or at least your stats go further here in just a moment. We need to take a quick break. Lady Rams lead by one here after two quarters. This is Mount Vernon basketball from WMIX Sports.
Valentine's Day is coming, which means love is in the air. If you've been hit by Cupid's arrow, don't forget to get a gift for your sweetheart. This is Chase Landers with Landers Towing and Collision Center. Why not let us offer you a unique idea for the love of your life? Give them the gift of a showroom clean vehicle with one of our premium details. Just call us to make an appointment for an easy surprise, or come, get a certificate, and we'll do the job when it's convenient for you. It's that easy. We promise to love you for it. If you are looking for Cupid, don't forget to watch out for Murray the Deer and his friends. The Mount Vernon and Salem locations have set aside 50 free deer whistles for anyone who is interested in coming and picking them up. Yes, we have 50 deer whistles to give away to the first customer to ask for them. We are here for you whenever you need us. Landers Towing and Collision Centers in Mount Vernon and Salem. Call 1-888-LANDERS. That's 1-888-LANDERS. And keep an eye out for Murray the Deer in Salem. I hear he plans to make an appearance at a few local businesses soon.
Hi, this is Steve Downs, Vice President of Agricultural Lending with Community First Bank. Operating your farm operation is extremely challenging in today's farm economy. Your operation needs a solid partner that understands the issues you face while providing solutions that make sense for you. At Community First Bank, we're dedicated to meeting the needs of local farmers just like you. Give me a call today at 618-244-3000 to see how we can help with your farming operation. Community First Bank, with locations in Mount Vernon, Woodlawn, Dixon, Ina. Welcome back to Personal Banking, member FDIC.
Look for exclusive videos on our YouTube channel. This is Lady Rams Basketball from WMIX Sports.
WMIX FM, WMIXSports.com has your streaming video tonight. 29-28 the score here for your Second Chance Auto halftime show. For over 36 years, they have been saving you hundreds, even thousands, with its bank rate financing for all, doing that off the total cost of your vehicle at Second Chance Auto, making your tax dollar go further. So do not stop and make an auto purchase without first seeing Second Chance Auto. 1-point ball game here at the break. We'll tell you how it became that way with your scoring and stats. Lady Rams on the inside were 3 of 11 in that first half, 6 of 14 from three-point land. That made a huge difference. They were 9 of 25 from the floor. Lady Tigers were 6 of 17 from two-point range, 4 of 9 from the outside. They were 10 of 26 from the floor shooting in that first half. 5 of 9 for Lady Rams from the stripe, 4 of 8 for the Tigers. Herrin out rebounded Mount Vernon 16-11. Turnover disadvantage fell with the Lady Rams 6-5. Individual scores first for Herrin. They had 6 points apiece for Madison Russell, Madison Laquat, and Berlon Mack. Three apiece from Brooke Gerald and Michaela Smothers, and two apiece from Moore and Groudage. Four of the Lady Rams are led by Jasmine Hawkins in her game-high 10, 9 from Peyton Hayes, 5 from Kate Bashu, 3 from Lauren Heinzman, and 2 from Madeline Keel. And there you have it. That's our halftime score. The Mount Vernon Lady Rams 29, the Herrin Lady Tigers 28. We'll come back, set up the second half, update you on some scores from around the area, and a whole lot more. This is Lady Rams basketball from WMIX Sports.
Ford Watson offers two convenient locations to serve you here in Mount Vernon. Our locally owned Health Mart Pharmacy at 3401 Broadway provides dedicated and specialized pharmacy services, including flu vaccines, a convenient drive-thru, online refill services, and a mobile app. At Bird Lesson Drug, we take the time to get to know you, explain your medications, and answer questions you may have. At 1200 Main Street, our medical equipment store has a large selection of lift chairs, scooters, and other mobility equipment to meet your needs. Come in and check out our large selection of scrubs, including Wonder Wing, Carhartt, Grey's Anatomy, Certainty, Cherokee, and much more. The extremely comfortable clogs are great for people who are on their feet all day and made here in America. Bird Watson also has a large selection of compression stockings in a variety of colors and patterns. Stop by Bird Watson Pharmacy at 3401 Broadway or our medical equipment and scrubs location at 1200 Main Street. Bird Watson, specializing and expanding to provide patients and medical professionals with specialized service and expanded product offerings. Let's take a pop quiz. If you rent a house or apartment, then your landlord is financially responsible in case of fire, theft, or other catastrophes. True, right? Wrong. It's false. Very, very false. Hi, I'm Shauna Armstrong, independent agent at Page Insurance in Mount Vernon. The Insurance Information Institute warns the only disaster protection is to purchase a renter's insurance policy. We offer several levels of protection with flexible deductibles and due dates. Come see us at Page Insurance on Crowdy in Mount Vernon or call 242-7000. Do you want to help your business make a lasting impression? At Winning Edge, we specialize in embroidery and screen printing on polos, jackets, t-shirts, hoodies, and more. We can outfit your staff so your business will portray the image you want. Your logo will be prominently displayed for all your customers to see. Get a free quote from Winning Edge today by calling 244-9070. And hey, Rams fans, don't forget to stop by Winning Edge in downtown Mount Vernon to see our brand new Rams apparel. Find us at 212 South 9th Street.
Watch the Lady Rams online at WMIXSports.com, powered by Red Lake College.
WMIXFM, WMIXSports.com has streaming video here from Herrin, where the Lady Rams lead at the half. The score is 29-28 with Danny Czerwinski. I'm Chris Hugo in D.C. Big night for the Lady Rams, but it appears a big night for some other county girls basketball teams as well.
SVW, Lady Devils have won their regional title over Johnson City. Woodlawn has beaten Gallatin County, regional champs. So Woodlawn goes to the Gordville sectional. SVW goes to the Trico sectional. So some showcase teams racking up the hardware tonight.
No doubt about it. Obviously a big night for Lady Cardinals. It's a 5-seed. They win a regional. And SVW, I believe, is a 3-seed in their subsectional. Beats, wins on their home turf. Can't beat that. Scoreboard updates are presented by Bird Watson Home Medical in Mount Vernon. If you're on your feet all day at work, remember Bird Watson's great selection of stylish Asics and clogs. No sacrificing looks for comfort. Your feet will love you for it. Remember, one name for Asics and clogs. Bird Watson, 12th and Main, Mount Vernon. Find them on Facebook. Lady Rams, D.C. had an 8-point lead at 22-14. Herrin battles back just as Lady Rams had done a quarter prior. And now it could be anybody's ball game here in the third and fourth quarters.
It could be. Could be anybody's game here. Somebody's not paying attention as we get ready to go here. Multitasking sometimes is good, sometimes bad.
Yeah, tonight I'm feeling like I'm struggling with it. But be that as it may, we move on and into the second half. Lady Rams start with the basketball. Hayes wide open for a three, dials it up from downtown. She has four trays tonight. A game high 12, and it's 32-28. Lady Ram lead two possessions with 7:45 remaining. Here in the third, short corner, that's Madison Russell to the right wing for Smothers. Underneath, Laquat battles the defender, uses the glass. She has eight, and it's 32-30. Community First Bank reminds you that if your bank has changed names again, it's not you, it's them. Community First Bank can help you switch with that one checking. Free checking and high yield interest. It's known as one. You'll love it. Short corner pass will be to Hawkins. Up two, 32-30. That's off the official, who's not in play apparently. It'll be Herrin basketball. 7:15 to play in the third. 32-30 the score. Herrin with it into the left corner for Madison Russell. Short corner jumper is going to be way long, and the rebound will go to Ms. Hayes. So a big defensive board for the Lady Rams, who lead by just two. They've led since the end of the first quarter. Had to battle back from a major deficit. Down 9-0 at one point. Left corner, this is Bashu off of a trap. Off the double team, she'll find Hayes. Tie ropes the sideline, goes back door to Hawk. Her shot blocked out of bounds. It'll be Mount Vernon basketball, and another chance for the Lady Rams.
Yeah, another chance.
So now, left of the bucket. Lady Rams will inbound off of the swat out of bounds. 6:48 left to go in the third quarter. 32-30 the score. Lady Rams up two, looking to add some more to the lead as they throw to the free throw line for Keel. Slips it back to Heisman. She'll try to drive, throws up a wild shot, bailed out by a foul, into the line to shoot two will go Heisman.
Yeah, good move. Christopher is leading whoever 53-46 late in that one. And Bearcats are up five now. So go through the Twitter line trying to find that. Put some new stuff on there about the Lady Devils and the Lady Cardinals. And then Meridian beats Cobden 68-59. That's the first regional title for that girls' program since 1980.
Lady Rams made one of two free throws that time to extend the lead to three, then got the rebound underneath but lost it on the turnover. The other way goes to Herrin, and this will be a travel out of the short corner. Thought it was a good move by Madison Russell, but they disagree. It'll go the other way. Somebody will stop to tie their shoes at the timeline with 6:28 to go in the third. 33-30 the score here from Herrin. Memorial Gymnasium, one of the finer facilities if you like the bowl-style gymnasiums. Heinzman deep in the backcourt. Behind the back dribble to get across the half line. Now to the left elbow. Kicks out for Hayes. Right-hand dribble for Peyton. Looks to Bashu. Nice back-footed catch. And now finds Hayes. Lady Rams almost lose it. Recovered by Heinzman. She'll try to attack the baseline. Shut off. Traveled with the basketball. And third turnover of the quarter for Mount Vernon.
Weber loses 59-49 to Christopher. So Christopher in her first year wins a regional. And I believe Woodlawn will play Christopher, I think. Or is that right?
Huh.
No?
Left out. Can't play somebody in your own subsectional as they roll off to the left block.
All right.
For Groutage. Ties it. Actually brings it to a one-point game, 33-32.
Corville's also ringing a bell for me.
5:45 left to go in the third quarter. Right wing, three on the way would be big by Heisman. No good. Peyton Hayes skies for the rebound, but... Double dribbles, turnover Mount Vernon. Good grief. As Herrin wants a timeout, presented by Purcell Tire and Service Center at 1212 Broadway in Mount Vernon. They are very proud supporters of the Mount Vernon Rams. Seasons, you never know when they're going to change. They've been on and off so far this year. It's time, regardless, to get those tires checked. Purcell Tire in Mount Vernon offers the new Hunter Quick Check System. They check tire tread depths, air pressure, charging, diagnostic, battery, and alignment on less than 5 minutes at no charge. 33-32, Lady Rams by one, and sloppy play from both teams to start the second half.
Mm-hmm. Not what either one of them wanted, but as it is, have to play on. Woodlawn will play at 6 o'clock against Meridian. And Christopher plays at 7:30. Against probably would be Gorville.
5:38 to go in the third quarter here in Herrin. The Lady Rams by one. 33-32 score off the left. This is going to be Smothers back to the wing for Madison Russell. Looks now to Moore. Moore past a diving defender, but a great job by the Lady Rams forcing the turnover. Second of the quarter for Herrin. Into the front court they go. It's Hawk beyond the arc. Dribbles into the short corner. Passing lane, not there. Herrin had their hands up on the double team, and it'll go the other way on the Lady Ram turnover. Yikes. And now a foul on Mount Vernon. It'll leaving them up at one here in the second half. 33-32, Lady Rams by one with 5:10 to play in the third. Off of the right wing. That is Moore with the basketball for the Lady Tigers. Looks off near the corner for Smothers. Throws across away. Madison Russell for the lead. Looks good. It's going to be short. Rims off the back. Pick up by LaQuat. She'll throw it to the outside for Smothers on the offensive rebound. She'll dribble in. Misses the jumper. Herrin, you got it. Got the rebound. Now Russell gets the last laugh. Try to three. Ends up with a two.
Too many chances that time. Got a box out along the way.
34-33 Tigers with it at the right elbow. Lady Rams will throw it away again. Unless that was tipped. It's not. They look short corner, but the passing lanes aren't there, especially as such, with 4:35 left in the third, a one-point ball game, 34-33. Herrin with the lead in the basketball. Winning Edge can customize tens, hundreds, thousands of T-shirts for your next event. Find them downtown Mount Vernon at 212 South 9th. Or log on to winningedgeusa.com. Between the circles, this will be Smothers looking inside. Good turnaround coming. Groutage knocks it down. She has four in the quarter, and it is 36-34. Deep left wing for Peyton Hayes. Right hand dribble now to Heinzman. Lady Rams trail by three to the elbow keel.
Oh.
Yikes. Got away with the travel there. Bashu wants a three. It's short. Rebound will go into the corner for Herrin. Third quarter has gone anything but well for the Lady Rams now. Herrin the other way. There's Groutage again. Back door.
Transition. Timeout. Jeff Lana was not happy the way Lady Rams got back defensively that time. They really didn't get back.
Don't foul out on your next road trip. Go to Purcell Tire for a free safety inspection. Purcell Tire, 1212 Broadway in Mount Vernon, where they treat every car like it's their grandma's car. And they love their grandma's. 38-33 now. Herrin's up five on a bit of a run here in the third quarter, and it's just not been aesthetically pleasing for the Lady Rams.
Back and forth we go. Right now, Herrin has the momentum.
That they do here in the third quarter, trying to make some things happen, taking advantage of Lady Ram turnovers, able to find points with good ball movement. Lady Rams, conversely, have not had good ball movement, unfortunately. Probably what's led to their six third quarter turnovers here as Jeff Lana looks to straighten them out in the timeout huddle.
Yeah, Mount Vernon did not get back that time. Absolutely did not get back defensively. So, unfortunately for Mount Vernon, they got back on a streak here. All that work they did to take the lead, get in front, all that good stuff didn't come to fruition, and now Herrin has been on a roll.
.345 to go in the third. It's 38-33. Off of the baseline, a link to the floor inbound here for Jasmine Hawkins.
Christar Rock Lutheran beat Marissa 47-28. And Flora beat Mount Carmel 47-34. It's interesting.
Oh, so that was a semifinal with Oakville then.
Yeah.
Gotcha. 3:30 left to go here in the third. Lady Rams had it tipped out of bounds. They'll save possession. Mount Vernon trailing by five the way since the latter part of the first quarter, and now Herrin back up five with 3:28 left out of the side out of bounds on the far side. They'll kick it into the right corner for Hayes. To the right wing, now to the top for Keel. Heinzman wants a right wing three. It's short. Rebound, nobody there. And the Lady Rams able to save it somehow. Looking back door, tipped out of bounds. It'll be Herrin basketball in the turnover. Oh, I thought they said white. My apologies. It'll remain Lady Ram basketball. So Lady Rams save possession yet again. This time a deep pass into the left wing for Hayes into the corner for Hawkins. Back to the top for Heinzman. They'll throw off to Peyton Hayes. Wasn't ready. Turnover Mount Vernon. And then now off the seventh turnover, two more. Lady Tiger points. This is Moore. Makes it 40-33. The lead seven for Herrin. Lady Rams trapped themselves. They're off of the left block and now bailed out by a foul.
Yeah, Lady Rams got bailed out by a foul. And one of the things here is that Mount Vernon has got to start getting something going offensively here as things are not flashing appropriately for Mount Vernon offensively.
I assume made the free throw. Made them both.
Yep, 40-36.
2:49 to go in the third quarter. 40-35 score. Lady Rams are down five. Herrin with the basketball. Off of the left wing, this is Smothers. Community First Bank of the Heartlands, the official voice of the Rams and Lady Rams. Man, As off of the right side, Lady Rams will pick up a foul. That'll be against Hayes.
Calling it tight.
Just tough. As Russell will try a three from the left side, it's no good for Herrin. Rebound will go to Hayes. Big rebound from Mount Vernon. 2:28 left to go in the third quarter. Again, Community First Bank of the Heartland reminds you, if your bank has changed names again, it's not you, it's them. You'll love this one at Community First Bank. Free checking, high yield interest. Coming out of the right corner, that is Hawk. Recovered by Heinzman. Now dribbling to the top of the key. Throws the outside for Payton. She'll throw past a screen. Now to the top of the key, Keel. To Hawkins outside. Big three if it goes. No good. Backdoor rebound for Bashu. Saves it to Heinzman, who knocks down the jumper. They needed that.
Yeah,
bad way.
And it's amazing because Mount Vernon's kind of like the Phoenix. About the time they get burnt up, they rise from the ashes and get back to within one possession again here late in this third quarter.
Smothers throws it away for Herrin as the Tigers turn it over. And now looking for the home run toss, but nobody paying attention. Wow. Now back to the right wing and through the wicket. Stolen away by Herrin. Another Lady Ram turnover there. Eighth. More points for Moore off the turnover. No good. Couldn't come up with a shot. Lady Rams will get the rebound, however. And now they will go the other way. 90 seconds left to go in the third quarter. 40-37 ball game between the circles. Lauren Heinzman, right-hand dribble for the senior. Looks off to the left for Keel up top. Now deep left wing for Peyton Hayes with a minute 18. Finds Heinzman now near the short corner. This is going to be Hawkins. Nice pass to the top. Hayes is wide open left wing three for the tie. It's good. Signs of life from the Vernoy, and now tied at 40 with a minute 4 to go in the third.
7-0 run.
Looking left wing for Madison Russell. Now to the top for Smothers. Lob pass to the right side. Moore out of the sideline. Gets it right back. Smothers wants the 18-footer. Dials it up, no good. Rebound to the Lady Rams, who have started to pick up the glass. Looking for the lead. We're tied at 40 with 40 seconds left to go in the third. Off of the left sideline, it's Peyton Hayes. Right of the circle for Heinzman with 33 seconds left. Hayes back to the right for Heinzman. 27 seconds to go. Tied at 40. Probably wanting the last shot as Hayes had it left half line. Herrin Lake College Powers are streaming. Log on to rlc.edu to see how you can save thousands on the total cost of your education. We'll look for our Tony Wilt State Farm Stars of the game in our postgame shows. Heinzman will drive into the defender, leaves it off at the front of the iron, and no good. Rebound will go the other way with the Tigers with 4 seconds. They'll dribble into the front court with two. Lost, recovering. Off balance, shot at the buzzer is good out of the short corner.
Yep. On cue.
And that will take us to the fourth quarter. Herrin 42, Mount Vernon 40. This is Lady Rams basketball from WMIX Sports.
Ever feel like you're paying your bank to be there for you? Hi, I'm Debbie Ashby with Community First Bank, and we believe being chosen as your financial partner is a privilege. That's why we still offer free checking with free debit cards and free online banking and bill pay for your convenience. No hassles, no hoops to jump through, just your local hometown bank being there for you. Stop by one of our 5 Jefferson County locations today to see the Community First difference and let us welcome you back to personal banking. Community First Bank with locations in Mount Vernon, Woodlawn, Dixon, Ina. Member FDIC.
Hey, Mom and Dad, take the stress out of paying for college by getting your high school grad higher education started with Herrin Lake College. At just a fraction of the cost of a 4-year university, Herrin Lake College can give your son or daughter a high-quality head start before transferring to a university without breaking the bank. Take the worry out of paying for college. Call 618-437-5321 or log on to rlc.edu. Herrin Lake College, your journey starts here.
Streaming worldwide at WMIXSports.com. This is Mount Vernon Lady Rams basketball.
8 third quarter turnovers, and somehow the Lady Rams are within 2. Herrin made a heck of a shot inside the buzzer as they were chasing out of bounds, just thrown up by Moore for a prayer, and it puts Herrin on top. They have the basketball. Moore with it now off the left wing into the corner for Russell. Tiptoe three. No good. Rebound will go to Mount Vernon. Had a great idea, just couldn't finish, and now Lady Rams have it. Left sideline, Peyton Hayes with the basketball for the Lady Rams. Left corner for Bashu from Hayes. Off the double team, she's trapped, able to find Keel. It'll be tipped to Peyton. Comes up with it, gets past the defender. Has it stolen away, and finally, after 3 pairs of hands in there, foul call. It'll stay with the Lady Rams.
Stay there. Yeah. Mount Vernon battling here. Got a lead, trying to get back another one here.
So now they'll inbound right of their bucket. Finding Hayes in the corner, tough pass. She'll come up with it, though. Runner in the lane, not there, but she'll go to the line. Not going to go to the line to shoot, too.
Nope. So it was a push-off. Okay.
Oh, maybe not.
Yep, that's right.
Okay.
So people are confused by the lack thereof or mechanic
thereof. Not very good mechanics. I'm just going to be honest.
No. End of the year.
We all get that way.
Yep.
Hayes misses the first. She'll have another. She has 15 tonight, all from beyond the arc. Take care of that. Second one's good, though. She makes 1 of 2. Has 16, and it's 42-41. Nail-biter could be developing here from Memorial Gymnasium. Who will your Tony Wilt State Farm Player of the Game be tonight? Good shake-off of the defender by Moore. Madison Russell all open in the corner. It's good. Nobody there to guard. What else is going to happen? She has 11. It's 45-41. Big effort by Herrin.
Quality 3A game tonight.
As now the other way, Lady Rams in some trouble as Heron's defense picking up. Played pretty well tonight. Short corner pass for Hawkins. She'll recover beyond the arc and now trying to force feed. Almost throws it away. It'll be tipped out by Herrin. Lady Rams maintain possession. Finger pointing that time, unfortunately.
Mm-hmm.
As now Hawkins will throw it back to the outside for Hayes.
Mount Vernon got away with a travel and a double dribble.
Yeah, and ended up getting a bucket.
Yeah.
Cuts it in half, 43-45 with 6:37 to go. 18 points of the night for Peyton, making a case to be your Tony Wilt State Farm Player of the Game. Find Tony in his office. Look for him online at TonyWilt.com. See how you can get to a better state with State Farm. As Groudage has another one banked in, it's 47-43. One of these teams is going to have earned this victory here tonight from Memorial Gymnasium. Lady Rams are down 4. Will it be them? Out of a trap on the corner, Hayes trying to battle through, forced along the baseline. Able to find Hawkins. She'll dribble to the basket. She's fouled, and she'll go to the line to shoot 2. Man, you'd rather have an and one out of one of these. We're on Twitter at WMIX Sports, Facebook and Instagram as well. Lady Rams' next game will be on Monday, 5:45, your pregame on WMIX-FM and WMIXSports.com. We'll have your streaming video. As the first free throw good for Hawk, cuts it to 3, looking to make it a two-point game with 6:07 to play, and second one short, rebound to Herrin. Smothers with the right hand, dribble across the half line, out of the volleyball line, let's go over to Russell. Trying to lob inside, turnaround coming, it's no good. Rebound will be stolen away by Kate Bashu off of the Mac miss. And now Lady Rams get a big board. Down 3 with 5:48 left. And we'll have a technical or a timeout?
On Herrin. Oh, that's big. You're winning by 3 with 5:45 to go when you get a T griping at the official. Probably not the best technical to get in that situation.
So Peyton Hayes will shoot the technical shots, and the Lady Rams will have the possession. Sometimes you can't say the things you want to say, regardless of how many people are thinking it.
Yeah.
And now Hayes makes the first, looking to make Herrin pay. Now he'll have to sit the rest of the game.
Yeah. Coaching box taken away from him.
And the Lady Rams will have the possession down 1.
Now, Mount Vernon, there are times to get a technical and there are times not to get a technical. That's one not, because you have the lead. You let it go. You do take care of business another way.
Side out of bounds. It'll be into the Lady Rams down 1. Deep right wing, Bashu gives it back left of the circle for for Lauren. Now Hayes comes up, Bashu comes up with it, throws in the right corner. It'll be a skip pass from Hawkins to Heinzman. She'll pull up for a 3, had a couple people open. Rebound will go off to the weak side. It's to Herrin. They're up 1. So Lady Rams could have had the opportunity to take the lead, and this will be out of bounds. Good swing and a miss by Peyton Hayes as Herrin tried to throw backward.
Yep.
It'll be a turnover on the Tigers.
Good description there. Swing and miss. Didn't work.
She actually tried to tip it, and then thankfully she didn't. It rolled out of bounds over the baseline. Lady Rams got to get it in, though. Off a screen into the corner for Hayes. She'll dribble the right hand. Now throws to the elbow for Keel. Almost turned over, but recovered. They'll lob inside. There's Hawkins and one. We told you they needed one of those. There it is.
How hard has she worked tonight getting the hoop underneath and getting rebounds? As usual, the senior doing the work that needs to be done.
As now that will be her 13th point of the game. She'll look for 14 here at the line. Lady Rams are back on top, 48-47. Rinn Lake College powers our video streaming. Log on, rlc.edu. See how you can save thousands on your collegiate education. Your journey starts at Rinn Lake College. Three-point play, how about it? 49-47, the Lady Rams are up two, trying to hang on, trying for their 14th win of the year. You think without some of the disappointments along the way where their record would be, as Russell coming around off a curl, throws it away, big turnover for Herrin. And now the Lady Rams recover. They need a run. See if they can put one together here as it's lobbed across the timeline to the left sideline for Hayes. Deep right wing for Bashu. Back to Peyton, left of the circle with 4:42 to go in the half. Cade will dribble, trying to get her out of the trap and able to find Hines, but now to Hayes outside. She has five triples tonight. She has 20 for her efforts. Hawkins has 14. Not a bad twosome for Mount Vernon. Into the corner for Hayes. Ball fake with 4:19 left. She's trapped. Jeff Lawn is going to bail it out with a timeout. This timeout presented by Purcell Tire and Service Center. You'd rather have to call this timeout than a timeout down a couple after a couple of turnovers. So right now, Lady Rams save possession, D.C. They're up two and have to be proud of the inspired effort here.
And again, they battle right back. Isn't that weird how that all works? They battle right back and they see what's going on. They battle right back into this. And now have to maintain the lead now because of this game. They've fought back, battled, and all that good stuff, and then lost lead, and then gave it back to Herrin. So we'll see what happens now.
We've had a lot of back and forth throughout this one, starting from about the 11-10 mark of the first quarter. Lady Rams ended up leading after one, 12-11. They trailed 42-40. After three, after leading to the half, and now they're up two. So a lot of back and forth on this one. 4:18 to go in regulation. All the action presented by Community First Bank of the Heartland as we're in the midst of a Purcell Tire and Service Center timeout. Oddly enough, Purcell Tire also presents our closings and cancellations on WMIX. Weather could be getting nasty over the coming days. If it does, we'll have any closings or cancellations to report on WMIX94.com and on AM 940, 96.5 FM, and 94.1 FM, should they be necessary, and they may or they may not.
Nah, no snow days in my book. I just like snow days, being an educator in the daytime.
Well, superintendents with passwords may say otherwise, DC.
Yeah, I know. Some superintendents don't like to use those passwords either.
No, they don't.
Yeah.
It's coming off left of the circle out of the inbound. This is Heinzman. Looks off a bounce pass to Hayes. 4:10 to go in the fourth. To the basket, it's long. Rebound will be tipped out. It'll be last touched by the Lady Rams by my vantage point. Are you kidding me? Is this Mount Vernon basketball?
I think the technical didn't help Herrin.
Eek.
Somebody's got a grouchy streak in him right now. Stripes.
Hayes off of the inbound from Hawkins. Dribbles through traffic. Able to find Bashu. Now to Lauren Hines, but it'll drop below the four-minute mark here. 49-47, the Mount Vernon lead. Tough place to play. Great 3A program, was a proud 2A, now a great 3A. This one has actually come about, this matchup, because Herrin did go into 3A. Needed a final week game, and there were the Lady Rams who had an open date way back when. 3:43 to go in the fourth quarter. Between the circles, this is Heinzman. Now dribbles to the elbow, kicks outside to Kate. 3:35 to play. They've actually killed about 30 seconds off the clock. Looking to make it more. Right of the circle, this is Heinzman. Lady Rams are in the bonus, mind you, so if Herrin feels the need to foul, that'll put the Lady Rams at the line. As the elbow right now, here's Hawkins. Short corner, Keel wants the shot, no good. Rebound by Hayes. She'll fight for position, get to the bucket, she's fouled, and to the line to shoot two.
Physical rebound there by Peyton. Great job for her, crashing the boards, getting in there amongst the tall timber.
And as a foul is called, she'll go to the line to shoot two to try to extend this to a two-possession game with 3:16 to go.
So Woodlawn gets Meridian Monday night at 6 o'clock at Goreville.
So you'll be in Goreville Monday night.
I'll be in Goreville. Already confirmed.
Shorty, let them know you're coming.
Yeah, we're
Sloppy
good.
Joe's already ready.
And I don't know. I already charged our setting up fee and spot to the baseball coach down there. And then Cesar gets Central, Breeze Central at Trico.
1-2 that time at the line for the Lady Rams. That was Peyton Hayes. She has 21. 50-47, Lady Rams up a tray. Uh-oh, inside they work. That's going to be long, but the rebound, Groudage. She has been their player in the second half. Second chance points for Groudage off of the LaQuad miss. And the Lady Rams lead now just one, 50-49 with 2:55 left. Hines been trying to get herself to the free throw line, I think, as she dribbles in. Not going to get the call. Throws up a shot that's no good, and the rebound will go to Herrin. They're clamoring for a foul and not getting it as Smothers dribbles through traffic, and now a rinky-dink little hand check is going to be the third team foul.
Maybelline and Mary Kay have entered the building. Sesser will play Breeze Central at 7 o'clock on Monday.
Because they're doing, I think, what, a Monday-Tuesday semi-situation?
Yeah, Monday-Tuesday-Thursday. Gorville's going 2 on Monday and 1 on Thursday. If the weather does what it's supposed to do, we may not be playing on either day.
We'll see, as now a big three. As Russell knocks down another triple, and that puts Herrin on top, 52-50. Deep left wing, this is Peyton Hayes with the basketball. A little bit of disappointment the past two possessions for Mount Vernon. Wasted an opportunity earlier, now about to turn it over as they're fighting for position, and we will have a travel. Another turnover on Mount Vernon, and this is where they get a little bit of a lead, and Herrin starts to come right back.
Boys play tonight. Odin beats Sisney, 75-74.
Scoreboard updates presented by Bird Watson Home Medical, 12th and Main Mount Vernon, and now Bill Green wants a timeout, presented by Purcell Tire and Service Center at 1212 Broadway in Mount Vernon, where they treat every car like it's your grandma's car. And they love their grandmas. 2:05 left to go in the fourth quarter. Herrin will have the basketball up to 52-50. And how do I put this? You see the Lady Rams get a bit of a lead. You see them start to sniff opportunities by maybe getting to the free throw line and then trying to do too much in double teams and traps in traffic and squandering chances.
Squandering those chances, and it just does not go well.
So we'll see what happens down the stretch.
But Mount Vernon's got to start figuring that out, and they've got to start closing games. I mean, obviously, this far in the season, it's, you know, you're like, well, what happens? Well, you got to close those games out. If you don't do it starting next week, watch out. You will be playing softball or track before you know it.
No doubt. Lady Rams will have Centralia on Monday. 5:45 will be your pregame on WMIX FM. We'll have the tip at 6. From the Salem Regional against the Centralia Annies. 2:05 to go here in regulation. 52-50 the score. Lady Rams right now down 2. Herrin will have the basketball to side out of bounds. It'll be Michaela Smothers to inbound. Right of the circle, finds Moore, gets it right back. 2:03 left. 2-point game. We'll skip pass coming for Groudage. We'll see what they do here. Maybe some trickery to kill some clock. Moore with it on the right wing. Lady Rams are down a pair. Groudage beyond the arc. Now the shoe's on the other foot, and the Lady Rams only have 3 fouls. Looking backdoor, Groudage trying to work the defender, going to dribble it out. Clears out Smothers, head fake, foul. Called by nobody anywhere within the realm of the play, and it'll be a 4th foul on the Lady Rams. With a 4th on Heinzman, as now with a minute 39 left to the ice. Left of the basket on the inbound, Groudage with it. Minute 22 to go in this one. 52-50. Lady Rams are down a pair. Smothers, deep left wing, looking to feed the free throw line. They'll swing it out to Groudage. Smothers has it. Dull ball chase, and now we'll have a push away from the shot.
Oh, my. Okay.
So now Herrin in the bonus with a minute 11 left. 52-50, the Lady Ram deficit. Smothers will inbound. In the far corner, Smothers going to roll with a left-hand dribble to the circle with a minute 6. Now Moore with it beyond the arc, and she's fouled by George. No call. Turnaround coming is in and out by Groudage. However, the putback, no. LaQuad can't come up with it either off the second chance. Not sure how they even got to that rebound, but with 58.1 seconds left, that'll be the 5th foul on Keel. She'll finish with 2 points.
Massac beat Benton tonight at home. Uh-oh. Girls. 45-31.
Really?
Edwardsville beat Alton 67-38. Yep. Massac beat him at home. Been there, done that trip before in different sports.
Oh, Massac was at home.
Yeah, Massac was at home.
Oh, okay.
When you make that trip to Massac, one, they're always good. Two, It's a tough place to play. Three, all the above.
First one,
four,
no good.
You got to ride a bus. Of course, they'll tell you they got to travel everywhere, so it is what it is.
LaQuat's second one on the way is good. Three-point ball game. Could have been two possessions, but she makes one of two. It's 53-50. Herrin on top, less than a minute to play. Kendall Ryan with the basketball. Throws over to the right for Bashu. She'll come around right wing. Push back beyond the arc. Picked up the dribble. Skip pass to Hayes, left wing. Peyton with the right hand. 45 seconds to go. It's 53-50. Right wing, Ryan. No, it'll be off the mark. And the rebound will go to Herrin. Probably not the shot they needed there.
No, probably not. A little bit rushed, and we'll head to the other end and shoot. Yeah, did not need a three there in that situation.
So Smothers will go to the line for the one and one. And Jeff Lonnen wants a timeout. Presented by Purcell Tire and Service Center at 1212 Broadway in Mount Vernon, where they treat every car like it's their grandma's car, and they love their grandmas. Let's see. Back at it tomorrow night, the Mount Vernon Rams welcome the Carbondale Terriers. Be a little bit of a different look to Carbondale as they come in on Hall of Fame night. We'll have it here on 94.1 FM. You can watch it live at WMIXSports.com. Third to last game at Chagnon. Of course, a reminder, you can get your tickets for the final game at Chagnon. That game is on December. We're in February. February 19th. Tickets will go on sale at 4 p.m. Monday. If you're a Jefferson County resident, you can have up to four. If you're not, then
too bad.
Yeah. And then students can have their tickets. They can buy them starting on Tuesday morning at 8. They can have one. So there you go. I guess they're expecting a big crowd for the Rams and Orphans, the final game in the history of Chagnon Gym. Hope the fire marshal had a predetermined vacation long before the game was scheduled. 53-50 the score here at the line as Smothers on the 1-1 with 39 seconds left. She'll make the free throw and have another. Lady Rams rushed into a three try. Their previous trip down the floor, and it ends up as a quick rebound foul. And now Smothers looking to get the second. Off the back of the iron, rebound to Hayes. Big rebound by Peyton. They're down four. It's 54-50. Less than a minute to go. A three from George is no good as they try another. This time the rebound by Peyton. She recognizes the situation. Tries to get to the basket. We'll have a jump ball. Possession arrow favors Mount Vernon. Jump ball to call. Oh, my.
Yeah, a little rush. Mount Vernon, their last two trips down the floor, wanting to get everything back and a quick shot, and had plenty of time to get one a little bit closer to the rim and do it that way.
George to Bashu on the right wing, and it'll be thrown away. They were looking for Hayes, left side. They turn it over. And now Herrin will save it as they nearly throw it away. Left corner, quick foul to the line to shoot. One and one will go more.
Down the stretch, Mount Vernon has not taken care of the basketball and or handled their possessions the way you would like to see.
So now more to the line for the one and one. And she will miss the one, not get the second, and the rebound to the Lady Rams. That was Hayes. Dribbling into the front court, crossover. It's up top, left wing, into the corner. This will be Ryan. Throws up a wild shot off glass. It falls. Timeout, Jeff Lon, and Lady Rams cut it in half, 54-52. As the Lady Rams, I don't think, had any timeouts.
Hold
left.
On. He called timeout. And I guess Mount Vernon may be out of timeouts.
I have them as out.
Yeah, I have them as out as well. And they call a technical on Jeff Lonnen. Jeff Lonnen saying he did not signal, or he started the signal timeout, didn't call it, and wanting to argue and will to no avail not be able to win the argument.
Well, I think deep down when you look around, you're not going to have the greatest of performances from anything involved. And now the first free throw is good by Russell in the technical shots. That'll extend it to three.
That too.
Yourself
yeah.
included.
Yeah.
Myself included. So, note to self, don't even get close to that.
It's just like on the golf course, can't call mulligans once you tee off first tee.
This quick inbound out of the technical. They made one of two, and now 2 seconds left. We'll have a foul deep in the backcourt on the inbound from side of the bounce.
So Mount Vernon will need a miss, or this one's over. It's like two magnets. They couldn't quite get it together.
Jeff Lyon will need a little reverse polarity on that one.
And half the audience left us.
Yeah.
When you did that.
1.8 seconds left.
Although I will
Science.
Say... Well, I will say that it would shock me. I've already seen that on the park test in the world in the last few years. So, you know, hey.
Second free throw, good. Makes both. It's 57-52. And from three-quarter court from Peyton Hayes and just coming up short. Final score in this one, Herrin 57, the Lady Rams 52. We'll come back with your Schmitzville Cadillac postgame show. This is Lady Rams basketball from WMIX Sports.
Mount Vernon Township High School Sports Hall of Fame inductee class of 2016 on Saturday, February 13th at Chagnon Gymnasium. Rams heroes being honored include Chad Hammonds, Tommy Hayes, Lindsey Wagner, J.W. Sanders, Jason Brooks, Jerry Wilson, and friend of the Rams, John Rackaway. Relive the memories of the 1908-09 and 1991-92 Rams basketball teams, as well as the 2001 girls cross country team. Tickets are available at One Stop Flooring America at 318 South 10th Street in Mount Vernon. Doors will open at 4:45, but dinner at 5:30. See you Saturday, February 13th at Chagnon.
Have you been dreaming of owning your very own new car, but think because you have less than perfect credit that will just never happen? Hi, Roy Schmo of the King City Chrysler Center. I'm telling you to think again. We have partnered up with Chrysler Capital, and we want to help your dream of owning a brand new car come true. Stop selling for a cheap ride that you constantly have to put money into just to keep it running. Now is your chance to own that brand new car you have always wanted and have the peace of mind that comes with a 3-year, 36,000-mile full coverage warranty and 5-year, 60,000-mile powertrain warranty. Come see us at King City Chrysler at 603 Broadway in Mount Vernon and let's see how Chrysler Capital can help you. Call for more information at 618-242-6600 or check us online at kingcitychrysler.com.
Don't let the high cost of auto insurance keep you from behind the wheel. I'm Shauna Armstrong with Page Insurance. We can help keep you legally insured with month-to-month coverage from Dairyland, with multiple ways to pay, no long-term upfront premiums, and the ability to choose your own due date. Dairyland could just be the coverage you need to keep you legal behind the wheel. And it won't break the bank. Call Page Insurance for a quote at 242-7000 or come see me on Crownview in Mount Vernon.
Dairyland Auto Products are underwritten by a member of the Century Insurance Group. Looking for a free checking account that still offers rewards for doing things you already do? Cha-ching! Available only at People's National Bank. People's National Bank wants you to get the most out of your money, which is why they offer Cha-ching Cash checking. Cha-ching Cash lets you earn really high rates paid in cash each month. You even get refunds on your ATM fees nationwide, so you can make any ATM your ATM. And there's never a minimum balance to earn any of your Cha-ching Cash rewards. People's National Bank. Member FDIC. Qualifications and rules apply.
Here's Jeff Schmidt for Schmidt Chevrolet Cadillac of Mount Vernon.
We've got 2016 Chevy Cruze Limited for as low as $16,775 for a brand new Chevy Cruze. That is an unbelievable deal right now. You know, the Cruze gets fantastic fuel economy. It's got a really, really nice interior. It's won numerous awards for safety. And people that buy the Cruze really do like them, and they seem to last a long, long time.
Schmidt Chevrolet Cadillac of Mount Vernon, 3423 Broadway in Mount Vernon.
This is Mount Vernon Lady Rams basketball from WMIX Sports. The Schmidt Chevrolet Cadillac postgame show starts now.
Final in Herrin, the Lady Rams tumble 57-52 to the Herrin Lady Tigers. Good evening from your Schmidt Chevrolet Cadillac postgame show. Schmidt Chevrolet's 3423 Broadway at Mount Vernon. Schedule your service appointments or browse for that new or pre-owned vehicle at schmidtchevrolet.com. With Danny Czerwinski, I'm Chris Hugel. We'll hear from Jeff Lawton, we assume, in just a moment. We'll also have your scoring and stats as well as your Tony Wilt State Farm stars of the game. It's all coming up. First, a quick break. This is Lady Rams basketball from WMIX Sports.
Hi, this is Steve Downs, Vice President of Agricultural Lending with Community First Bank. Operating your farm operation is extremely challenging in today's farm economy. Your operation needs a solid partner that understands the issues you face while providing solutions that make sense for you. At Community First Bank, we're dedicated to meeting the needs of local farmers just like you. Give me a call today at 618-244-3000 to see how we can help with your farming operation. Community First Bank, with locations in Mount Vernon, Woodlawn, Dixon, Ina. Welcome back to Personal Banking. Member FDIC.
Hey, Mom and Dad, take the stress out of paying for college by getting your high school grad's higher education started with Herrin Lady College. At just a fraction of the cost of a four-year university, Herrin Lady College can give your son or daughter a high-quality head start before transferring to university without breaking the bank. Take the worry out of paying for college. Call 618-437-5321 or log on to rlc.edu. Herrin Lady College, your journey starts here.
I'm Eddie Wild this day. Bowers will look at your next ride weather. It'll turn cloudy this evening, then a bit of snow from late evening on, leaving a coating to an inch by morning, a low 20. Tomorrow, cloudy through midday, and then breaks the sun later in the afternoon, a high 36. Partly cloudy and frigid tomorrow night, a low 7. Saturday, lots of sunshine, quite cold, on alley 23. Then we'll see some snow later Saturday night through Sunday. Next ride weather from WMIX, Mount Vernon, Illinois.
Find us on Facebook. This is Lady Rams Basketball from WMIX Sports.
WMIX-FM, WMIXSports.com for your Schmidt-Chevrolet Cadillac postgame show. Lady Rams fall tonight, 57-52 on the road in Herrin. Joined now by Lady Rams head coach Jeff Lonnen. Jeff, we know coming in, tough place to play. We know coming in, Herrin is a very, very good 3A program, and I really thought your team, maybe outside of a few moments, obviously played very well tonight, played their hearts out tonight in the regular season finale, and overall performed pretty well against a very good team.
Absolutely. I couldn't be more thrilled. I mean, we played toe-to-toe with them the whole time, and I think that this was a really good game to prepare us, the final game anyway, to prepare us and propel us into Monday night. Would have liked to get the win. That one could have gone either way. It was just a break here, a break there. But, you know, you can't split hairs. I mean, I think both teams did some things to win the basketball game, and in the end they just went on the one final little run, and we didn't. If there had been another 2 minutes in the game, we might have been the team that made the run and we'd have won. I think it was kind of a game of runs, if you noticed. You know, we went down 9, then we went ahead by 1 or 2, and then, you know, it just kind of seesawed back and forth like that, and they got the last run at us. So that's just kind of the way it is. We got in foul trouble, very hard to guard them whenever your starting point guard and your starting post player is sitting on the bench. I thought the kids that came off the bench did a heck of a job trying to plug those gaps. But in the end, you know, too much size probably down the stretch for us with those kids out of the game, and that probably cost us more than anything.
Well, I thought in a tight game that your girls responded well, especially the ones that were in foul trouble early, and I thought that they did well to last as long as they did in a contest like this one.
Well, yeah, I mean, They did really well, and I think Lauren especially, you know, did a heck of a job. I there was some question about whether the third foul was even on her or not. Somehow they came out of there and said it was on her. I'm not the official, so I can't dispute that or argue that. Maybe they had a better view of it than I did. But anyway, that doesn't matter. I mean, we still gotta, you know, play good defense, play with our feet, and not foul. You know, unfortunately, she fouled out, and at that point, you know, we tried some different things with significantly less size on the floor, and I think that's really kind of what got us. But, you know, overall, you know, it's a very hard place to play. Not too many teams come in here and win. I think Benton came in here and got beat 2 or 3 weeks ago, you know, about the same score, you know, and we all know how good they are. So we just think that, you know, we can take positives out of this for sure, and we certainly were very competitive, and you know, just get ready for that game on Monday night, because that's really all that matters now is Monday night.
Well, I thought in a game where everybody kind of got beat around a little bit, perfect preparation for a physical game that you know is coming on Monday night at Salem against the Centralia Annies. Your arch rival will be the rubber match. Winner advances to a semifinal on Tuesday against the number one Wildcats, so obviously, a lot of positives to be taken, as you just said.
Yeah, no question about it. We did get banged around. There's no question there. They do play rough, and they're pretty physical, and those big bodies are hard to handle. You know, we're going to see the same thing against Centralia. We're going to see the same thing against Salem. And you'll see them beyond. I mean, we just don't have the big bodies, it seems like, that everybody else seems to have this year. You know, we're small, and we have to rely on strength and technique to get position on the ball, and a lot of times we don't do a very good job of that, or else we're just not physically able to do that, and I think that gets frustrating, but it's not because they're not trying. I can tell you that. We just physically, it seems like about 8 out of 10 times we're just smaller and not quite as physical. And tonight was a great example of that. And I thought to hang in there as long as we did against that physicality was a good sign, you know. But I had no complaints. You know, our kids didn't do anything wrong tonight to lose the basketball game. I can tell you that. They could have won that game and did enough things to win it, but you know, it just didn't work out in the end.
Well, and definitely a close one throughout, especially you start out 9-0, ends up 9-3, and then you guys have a first quarter lead and just battled back and forth throughout. Not a lot of the time. You have to shake it off, move on to Centralia for Monday night. And maybe it's sometimes you can be misfortunate to have a team you're very familiar with in the postseason, but in a case like this, quick turnaround, maybe a benefit when you know them well.
Well, we do, but the other flip side of that is they know us pretty well, too. So, I mean, again, it'll come down to just kids making plays, but we definitely have to play better than we did the last time around. I thought we played pretty well up there and beat them there, and then they took it to us at our place. I think they were ready for us, and I think we were flat. And you just cannot be flat against them, no matter what kind of year they're having. They're turning into a pretty decent team now. I mean, they're up to about 12 or 13 wins like us. So I mean, we're very, you know, similar in the paths that we've taken through the season. We've both played exceptional schedules. We both have kind of seen our ups and downs. We both do similar things on the floor. We're both not extremely fast paced. We both run a lot of set plays. You know, and over the years, that's made for generally a pretty good, interesting, good basketball game. But it has to, I think the main thing that has to change from our last game here about a week and a half ago was we've got to play with more emotion and more energy. And I thought that kind of lacked the last time we played them at home. And I don't even have any idea why. I mean, that's just kids. But, you know, emotion and energy is a lot of, you know, not necessarily your X's and O's. So I thought we had great emotion and energy here tonight after we went down 9-0. But, you know, I didn't think we were particularly good up to that point. So we have to be mentally sharp, ready to play. They'll be well coached as they always are. You know, hopefully we'll do our best job and see where the chips fall. But we'd love to get that win and get our 14th win on Monday night.
No doubt. And then a semifinal appearance on Tuesday. Jeff, thank you for the time. I know it's a tough place to play, tough team, and all in all, performed very well. Very proud of your girls.
Well, thank you, and I'm proud of them, too. You can bet that, and I told them that in the locker room. And, again, they have nothing to hang their heads about. And, you know, the losses are disappointing, but I can assure you they played well enough to win tonight, just didn't quite break their way. We're fighting, and that's the main thing. And this time of the year, you look at there's some teams out there that, you know, they're going to go two ways. They're either going to look to end it and get out, and they want it to be over, or you're going to have to see teams that are still fighting. And we're certainly still fighting, as you saw tonight. So that's all you can ask for as a coach.
Well, certainly is, Jeff. Thank you again. 57-52 the final in this one. As we take a look quickly at your individual scoring, first for the Herrin Tigers, they had 12 from Hannah Groutage, 9 from Madison LaQuat. Can't forget about the 15 from Madison Russell, 6 apiece from Berlon Mack and Obunya Moore, 3 from Brooke Gerald. And that's it for Herrin. For the Lady Rams, a game-high 21 from Peyton Hayes, 14 from Jasmine Hawkins, 8 from Lauren Heinzman, 5 from Kate Vachou, 2 from Madeline Keel. That gives us our final score of Herrin 57, Lady Rams 52. We'll take a break, come back with your Tony Wilt State Farm Stars of the Game. This is Lady Rams basketball from WMIX Sports.
Mount Vernon Township High School Sports Hall of Fame inductee class of 2016 on Saturday, February 13th at Chagnon Gymnasium. Rams heroes being honored include Chad Hammonds, Tommy Hayes, Lindsey Wagner, J.W. Sanders, Jason Brooks, Jerry Wilson, and friend of the Rams, John Rackaway. Relive the memories of the 1908-09 and 1991-92 Rams basketball teams, as well as the 2001 girls cross-country team. Tickets are available at One Stop Flooring America at 318 South 10th Street in Mount Vernon. Doors will open at 4:45 with dinner at 5:30. See you Saturday, February 13th at Chagnon.
Hi, Matt Collier here from Automart of Salem. Getting a tax time loan? Automart of Salem has programs with down payments starting as low as $500.
check out our new no-pressure process. You buy here, you pay here. It really is that simple. Come see me, Matt Collier, Automart Estate, next to Schmidt Ford, or call 618-548-8611. That's 618-548-8611.
All right, I want to ask you something, but you have to promise not to laugh at me.
Okay, what?
Do you think the State Farm jingle really works?
Like, for real? Like, did you sing the jingle? Will your agent actually appear and help you out?
Yeah, of course it works. I saw it on the internet.
In reality, having your own State Farm agent means having a real person to help you when you need them. Call me, Tony Wild, in Mount Vernon at 242-1421 or find me online at TonyWild.com.
This is Mount Vernon Lady Rams basketball from WMIX Sports. The Tony Wild, State Farm Player of the Game, is next.
One final time from Herrin, 57-52. The final. Herrin wins it tonight over your Lady Rams. We owe you 3 stars of the game, presented by your State Farm agent in Mount Vernon, Tony Wild. Log on to TonyWild.com. Get to a better state with State Farm. Your number 3 star is Madison Russell, who had 5 big 3s off of the bench for the Lady Tigers. Number 2 star, Jasmine Hawkins, with 14 points. And your player of the game tonight with 21 points, a game high, is Peyton Hayes. Tony Wild, State Farm Players of the Game, appear on our website at WMIXSports.com every Monday. We'll get her face and details up there before you know it. Next broadcast for us will be tomorrow night. The Mountford and Rams welcome the Carbondale Terriers in South 7 play. Oh, yeah, it's also Hall of Fame night. We'll be on the air at about 7:40. Tip will probably be closer to 8. It'll be right here on WMIX-FM. Watch it live at WMIXSports.com. For Danny Czerwinski, for Audrey Southard, for Chris Mayberry, for all of us at WMIX Sports, thank you for watching and or listening tonight. Mount Vernon falls in girls basketball on the road to Herrin, 57-52. I'm Chris Hugo. Good night from Williamson County.